Hello student, this is part number 5 of our course. This lecture course, actually the lectures belong to my teacher, Dr. Pontip Chantra Mongkon. She created this lecture note and it's very useful for you. Well, this is the Beachscape. This picture is show the species diversity of organism group in this world. The size of them show the diversity. In this world right now, the highest species, highest group in the world is belong to insect. The second is plant. The next is other arthropods. And the others depend on their size. Well, this is the meaning of each group of organism. Well, then in this world we contain very very high diversity of animal, and the classification and nomenclature is need, because if we have the very good classification, we can categorize and grouping the organism in this world, and we can understand more about them. It's similar to the lecture course, the first lecture course. It's talk again systematic and taxonomy. Systematic and taxonomy, the meaning of two words is similar, but right now the popular one is systematic, because the systematic include the idea of evolution to the classification, and taxonomy I just talk in the lecture note, the first lecture note already. Taxonomy is contained the three important ideas. This is the three important idea in taxonomy or systematic. The first one is identification. Second one is classification and nomenclature. All of them I already talked in the first lecture. And again, we use this taxonomic ranking for all organisms in the world. Everybody in biology are familiar with this ranking already. From the phylum to the species or subspecies. Taxonomic unit or taxa is the word that maybe refer to a phylum, sometimes refer to family. This is the word that we talk about one group of organism. The species smallest group of organism that can interbreeding naturally, and their population can reproduce the offspring, and their offspring can breed and have their offspring. Then this is the meaning of species. Each species contain unique characteristic. This is the each species must have unique development, unique external and internal anatomy, unique correlation, cytology, physiology, and also in ecology. Then we can diagnose the species from the idea each species contain the character that unique that not have in the other species. We call diagnostic character. This is the meaning. The character that found and useful in distinguish or identify the species from its relatives or from the other species. If we have the specimen, especially for insect, we can use the genitalia, the sex organ. The sex organ is very important character in identification of insect and for many kind of species too. Because why we use genitalia as the ultimate character? Because the genitalia form not adapt, because if they adapt the genitalia form, it cannot breed. The male cannot breed to the female, then it's become extinct. Then the genitalia is the character in organism that not adapt along the evolution. And each species contain unique character of the genitalia. Look at here, the diagnostic character for the big animal like the horse group, the horse, equus ferus, the donkey, and the zebra, they are same genus but different species. For the big animal like horse, zebra, donkey, the characteristic not difficult. We just look and we can distinguish from the character. But for insect, we have the problem because many kind of insect very similar in character, like this butterfly. They have very similar, but actually it's different species. But look the outside, they're very similar. Then we have to go to the detail of genitalia because this Cleola, they must have different genitalia. Then this is the example of genitalia of this one is a Cleola injectaria. The genitalia is formed like this, the male genitalia. Different Cleola, Cleola cucullata, male genitalia, the form is like this, different. Then for the organism that external organ very similar, we can look at the genitalia. Sibling species. Sibling species mean the two species that very close, because long time ago the organism, the two population might be isolated by effect of geography or the others. When the time is passed, two population have different way to evolution, and finally they separate and become the new species. Then we call sibling species, very close relation long time ago. But when the time passed, species one have their own way and species two have their own way. Long time passed, they cannot go back to be the same species. Polyphytic species, the same meaning, the species that was isolated by geographic, and then when geographical barrier occurred, the same species what separate, and then they become the new species. The recess or subspecies, also the polyphytic species, and recess subspecies is the like the first step of separation. If the time passed, two subspecies might become the new species. This mechanism we call speciation. Speciation is the process that distinguish or separate species away together. And if the time pass, the separate will be have their own way and they can become the new species. Then the second meaning is mean the process that two population gradually change along time by the influence of environment or influence of other, and then the new species occur. And the speciation is the cause that the origin of the diversity of species in this world. Then this world contain a very high number of species. Long time ago, they might be the same group, but the evolution passed, they split, become new species, and then we need a very good classification to understand and to categorize the high species of living things in this world. If we have evolution, the diversity will occur. Then this is the important between evolution, species, and the taxonomy. This is the speciation. This is the picture show the process. Long time ago, we might be have one species here, but the time passed. Like speciation to be B and C and D. The A long time passed. The big alphabet A become small alphabet A. How about B? B separate from A and then become B1, B2, B3, the same as C and D. This is the picture show the speciation process. Zoological nomenclature is need. Then with if we can classify them, if we classify animal to be the group, we need to give the name for them. And from lecture, the first lecture I already talked to you, right now we use the system of alineas. We use this system is very useful, and we use until now the binomial nomenclature. The first is the generic name, and the second is a specific name or specific epithet. We have the group that in your homework, ICZN for animal, we have ICZN to take care of this system until now. This is the some example. They have the system for animal family should follow by ED. For subfamily is ini. This is the suffix. This is the rule that ICZN set for us to categorize the animal to be family, subfamily, or tribes. This is the example. Aedes notoscriptus. This is the mosquito. This is the binomial nomenclature name. The first one is generic name, and the second is specific epithet. And sometimes we have the barrack here. This is the old name. Right now they not use, but sometimes they put here. This is the lower one is the trinomial name. Sometimes the scientists can separate the same species to be subspecies. This is for the example. This name is important, and how to get this name not easy. If the name is acceptable, we call availability of name. It means this name is right, is accepted by scientists. Then we call availability or available name. Available name again is mean the scientific name that the scientists accepted. How to get the available of name is not quite easy. This is the rule. The first, the name must be in the correct form. The first one is generic name in Latin, and specific epithet in Latin, and generic name and specific epithet. Second, the name must be published on paper, and after you write out the paper about your new species, if no one object it, the name will be available. Three, the name must have defined and contain the information. A species name should contain some information in the name. Number four, in the paper for publish the new species, must have the diagnostic description. If you go to the forest and got new species of insect, you have to write down the diagnostic description, the color, the size of wing, blah 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 blah, and the most important for insect, you need to write down the shape of male genitalia. This is the one important part in diagnostic description. Yes, and if you got the name already, you must have the specimen. We call Thai specimen. Law of priority, it means if you go to the forest and you are work on species A, and somebody else work on the species A the same with you, someone who can publish earlier, the name will be available. But if the second rank published the paper, it's become synonym. Okay, this is the law of priority. First come, first serve. Okay, the law of priority. But if the second person work on the same species, but it published, we call it a junior synonym. Keep it right the second rank. Okay, we call it junior synonym. Then the synonym mean one species have two scientific name. Like this one, this is the example. This butterfly in 1932, Talbot already published a Nepenthes pisa. Holobrunia. Talbot already published, and it's past 30 years. Kiryakov published again, and everybody check, scientists check, the Anephisa monotonia of Kiryakov is the same species of Talbot. Then Anephisa monotonia become the junior synonym. There are many law. I give the another example. Homonyms are different. Homonym is mean two species have one scientific name. Homonym is mean two species have only one name, and it's occur in inside. This is also use the priority rules. Then the first paper published, we give available name for the first paper. But the second paper will be junior homonym. The second paper published and the paper accepted and published, this name become junior homonym. Like this paper, two species, two animal, Hopkinsella baba and Hopkinsella clay and Minnesagen. The first come got the priority. Then Hopkinsella baba published first in 1938, but for the clay and Minnesagen will be the junior homonym because they're the second rank of published. Okay, this also occur in animal taxonomy. The name and the type, if you have proper name, you also have the types. This is the also the homework. It's mean if you publish the new species, you must have the specimen. You might be keep by your own, you might be keep it in the institute that can keep it better. Okay, then this is called type specimen. Type is mean the specimen that connect to the paper that you publish, and they have many types specimen right now. You can do your homework. I give you an exam for some important types. The first one is holotype. This is the very important types. Holotypes mean the ones single one that we select it for write down the definition. We select only one. If you go to the forest and if you are got 10 of them, you must be select only one to be the holotype. Then this is the important of holotype, and you have to register it and write down where it's this holotype was collect and keeping. Example number two, paratype, the second type, the paratype. For that, I give you example. If you go to the forest, got 10 specimen, the first one that you are used for write the holotype, the remaining 9 become paratype. Paratype mean the specimen other than the holotype that that author collect and we consider it. Then this is the other from holotype will be paratype, and they also have many type like syntype. Syntype is mean lectotype. Syntype you can find in your homework, and also lectotype. Lectotype also the one kind of type, and lectotype we use for the same purpose of type. Then they have many. You can do your homework and you will see they have many types for the specimen of. And also lectotype and neotype, they have many. One example is neotype. Sometimes holotype was disappear or holotype damage, we can say neotype. We use the same purpose as holotype. And this is how important of museum or important of the Thai specimen. Okay, not only ICZN take care about the systematic of animal, we still have many group like international code an official list and index. We also have the world catalog of major groups of organisms, and we also have the zoological record that collect the annual publication in zoology.